Rod Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Keith Walker's hilarious tale of death by error. The house that Clemont built. Starring Shelley Berman. In the Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company and Lazy Boy Recliners. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Filled with strange people, none the least of which is our old friend, Inspector Fouché. Join us now as the inspector leads us a merry but bumbling chase through this world of skinny models and fat designers.
This way, mademoiselle. It's very kind of you.
No, I am pleased that I can. I also could not stand the cigar smoke. Mm. Ah, voila, 27A. Please. I do not think he's funny, little man. Will you disturb?
He certainly seems to be enjoying his dream.
Look at that mischievous smile. Oh, he is strange. Can we not be sat down? He went to sleep.
I think his mustache is adorable, don't you?
Very French.
Oh, please wait me for the approach to Orly.
Oui.
Libby, Mademoiselle Man, it is nearly time.
Huh? Oh, thanks, Mimi. I feel marvelous. Oh, my heavens, he's still at it. Should we wake him?
I think yes. But why don't you and I will bring some cafe?
Oh, what's his name?
Monsieur Fouché.
Inspector Fouché, and you are under arrest in the name of the French Republic.
That's incredible. And look, he's still asleep.
Oh, we are very nationalistic,
no? Sir, wake up, Inspector Fouché. We're almost to Paris.
You will come with me. We know what to do with you.
Inspector, are you all right?
Huh? Oh, excuse me. I must have been dreaming. Are you a dream?
I don't think so.
But of course you are. Here, let these sad but wise eyes gaze.
Ooh. Inspector, are you okay?
Yes. I don't understand why these seats pop up like that.
Voila.
You have made the incontinence, huh?
Yes. The inspector thinks I'm a dream.
Inspector Emile Fouché of the Sûreté.
A chaton.
Oui, but an elegant one, no?
Oh, Libby, watch out.
When a Frenchman's moustache twitches like that, it means he has the scent.
Is she the angel? May we have our coffee?
Do we? Libby, enjoy your stay in Paris.
Thank you.
As your stay for a holiday?
No, I've come to write an article. On Henri Clemont.
Ah, he's the great designer. Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, he's a famous man. You are with him magazine?
Yes, Designers Daily. And you are with the police?
Oui. You see that man across the aisle?
Yes. Is he wanted?
No. I just thought you might like to see me arrest.
Inspector, you are pulling my leg.
Yes, but that is another matter. No, for the truth, I must tell you, I have been in exile.
Really?
Yes. I had been studying the police methods of your country.
Where, New York?
No, Fitzwilliam.
Fitzwilliam? Where is that?
New Hampshire.
Oh, is it a large city?
1,362 people. I confess it was a punishment.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did you have to stay long?
2 years. But I served a major murder case, and they have let me return to the Sûreté.
That's wonderful.
I will be up here to another look another purple fish in the eye again.
A purple finch? Is that a bird?
Oh, yes. It's a state bird of New Hampshire. Ruined my best suit.
We'd better fasten our seatbelts, Inspector.
Oh, yes. Do you perhaps need a ride from the airport?
That would be nice. Inspector.
No, Shelley.
You fasten your seatbelt to mine. Let's see. Number 10, Ruth and Placide. That's odd. I know I was expected. Maybe it's the wrong address. No, it's number 10. Hey, who... Hello? Hello? Anybody home? Oh, talk about spooky. Hello? I'll try the drawing room. Oh my. Well, there you are, Mr. Clemont. Forgive me for busting in like this, but the front door... Mr. Clemont. Sir, are you all right? Sir, you don't look at all well. Oh!
Mademoiselle, wake up. Mademoiselle.
What? Who are you?
I think you had better explain who you are before the police arrive.
Police?
That's right. Monsieur Clermont has been kidnapped.
But he couldn't. I just saw him a few minutes ago. What time is it?
2 a.m. I must insist. Who are you?
My name is Libby Mann. I've come at the request of Mr. Clermont to do a magazine article. Now, who are you and what is this about kidnapped?
I am Paul Bouchard. I am an associate of Monsieur Clemont. He did not tell me of your coming. Oh, the police. Pardon.
Hello? Inspector Fouché, Sûreté.
Ah, this way, Inspector Fouché.
Oh!
Is this where you found the note?
Inspector!
Ah, mademoiselle, man. How are you?
A bent, but the same.
You know this woman, Inspector?
Oui. And who are you, the butler?
No, I am Monsieur Clermont's associate, Bouchard.
Oh, yes, of course.
He said kidnap, Inspector. Did he tell you?
Here is the note they left.
A dozen eggs, 2 chickens.
Oh, sorry. Here it
is. Yes, please do not do that again. It is obstructing justice. May I sit down?
But of course.
So, is this your hat I sat on?
No, I believe it is yours, monsieur.
Oh, yes, of course. When did you receive this?
It was on the desk when I arrived. Miss Mann was on the floor.
You're sure it wasn't the other way around?
What?
Just seeing if you are on your toes.
Inspector, may I speak with you a minute?
Of course.
Outside?
Monsieur Bouchard, please, wait in the hall. What is it?
Inspector, when I came in tonight, the door was ajar. I came on in and I found Mr. Clemont sitting at his desk.
Yes?
I think he was dead.
Oh, well, that cannot be. Why would anyone want to kidnap a dead man?
I don't know, but I swear it's the truth.
I see. Monsieur Bouchard. Monsieur, I am taking the note. Now, I would advise you not to pay the ransom.
But, Inspector, we must. The full collection is soon due, and Monsieur Clemont must be here.
I insist.
I insist that we must.
I see. Have you received instructions as to what to do with the money?
Not yet, but the note does say they will contact us.
All right. I will post a guard on the house. Tap the telephone, just in case.
That is good thinking, Inspector.
Thank you. Mademoiselle,
Have you a place to stay?
No, Monsieur Clemont had invited me to stay here while in Paris.
Then by all means, you must stay.
Oh, I couldn't.
I insist.
He insists.
If you insist.
I insist.
He insists.
Oh, all right. I get the point. I'll stay.
Good. I will be around tomorrow. And Bouchon, do not leave Paris.
I can't.
Why not?
I live here.
Oh, yes. Oh, where? Good night. I will keep my eye on the house.
He's certainly right about that.
Why, Mr. Bouchard?
Because he's in the closet.
Good night again.
Mademoiselle, is he always like that?
I've only known him a short while, but I think so.
I think so, too.
Libby, old girl, this mystery is getting to you. What's that? Oh, it's terrible. Sounds like someone in pain. Hello? Mr. Bouchard? Sounds like it's coming from the attic.
Bouchard, please, I did not mean it. You are almost there,
Mr. Bouchard, are you up here? Yoo-hoo! I don't understand it. These stairs don't lead any place.
Jack, you can't leave me. What will I do? No one knows the business like you.
That's Bouchard. Now, who's he talking to?
What are you doing spying on me?
Sorry, I just happened to fall in.
You were, didn't you? Shout everything. Jacques, tell me what to do.
Mr. Bouchard, who are you talking to? Mr. Clemont.
Stay away from him.
Easy, Bouchard. Easy. Put that chair down. I'm not going to hurt you.
You might, Jacques.
It doesn't look as if anything would hurt. Don't do that. I can't stand to see a grown man cry.
Dead. I know it is dead. Mademoiselle, man.
That's the first truthful thing you said tonight. How did he die?
I did it. Didn't I?
Oh, there. Now tell Mama Man all about it.
Thank you. Merci. I did not mean to. I am so upset.
Yes, I can see that. Now tell me, how did Monsieur Clement die? Pass on.
We had a terrible argument. It was because of your visit.
My visit?
Yes. He told me that.
Mademoiselle Mann will come to do that story on the behalf of Clemont. That is final, Paul.
But it is time we shared our secret. I am tired of always being your junior associate.
You will do as I say. The world has come to respect the name of Clemont and his design.
But they are my design.
Ah, imbecile. I am the brains that makes this house the money.
Who? You steal. They are mine. Mine. The designs are mine.
Ah, you fool. To tell the world who they are, what their confidence.
Who? You speak of confidence. It was you who said, Paul, come with me, we will build the greatest fashion reputation together.
And we have.
Then I want what is due me. I wish you to tell this fashion writer who is responsible.
I will not. You cannot speak to the great criminal. My heart. Paul, my pills.
Who? Huh? Who? I will not call for that ruse again.
Oh, no. Now, here I am. It's my heart. Paul. Paul.
Jacques. It is real. Jacques. No, don't die. I am sorry.
Paul. Forgive me.
No, Jacques. You cannot die. Don't look at me like that. Oh, please, Jacques. I would not know what to do without you, Jacques. Jacques.
Then it was you who hit me on the head.
Oui. Forgive me. I panic.
Why did you hide him? And why the kidnap note?
Because I could not bear to part with him. Besides, all these years, everything has been in Jacques' name. I would not get a franc. He has a terrible son who will destroy the house that Clemont built. I thought if I sent a ransom note, they would pay me what is rightfully mine. Then I would let Jacques be bound in the house.
But you must tell the police. It is the only moral thing to do.
You truly believe this?
I do. But I promise you this.
I will write an article for the House of Clemont that will preserve the good name of Clemont and still give you your just reward.
Oh, you are a fine woman, Mademoiselle Ben, for an American.
Well, we try, Monsieur Bouchard. Are you ready?
You mean now, tonight?
The sooner we do it, the sooner Jacques Clemont can go to his final rest.
You are right.
But, Inspector, why are you bringing me here?
You will see, mon chéri.
The House of Clemont and Bouchard is proud to present this next election for the new four seasons.
Wonderful.
And we have you to thank, Mademoiselle Libby. Here, let us go into the office.
But how did this happen?
Inspector, after you. Inspector.
Out here.
Sorry, but I was not looking. Inspector, you are always the same. Tell Libby what happened.
Clement's will left everything to Monsieur Bouchard.
Oh, that's wonderful.
His doctor said that he knew about his heart months before we argued.
Then you mustn't blame yourself.
Thank you. I feel that it was inevitable. But I owe you a great deal. Would you and the inspector toast with...
We'll open the champagne. It is my specialty.
Oh, my eye... Inspector Fouché, your aim is formidable.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes, exercise your imagination, and join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
House That Clemont Built is an original radio drama written by Keith Walker. Shelley Berman was heard as Paul Bouchard. Featured in the cast were Peggy Walton, Luke Krugman, Ben Wright, and Maggie Mullooly. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Collis, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman, Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.